Hey, I'm Gutsy and welcome back to Gutsy's Garage. Today we're talking about fuel and not Melbourne Bitter. It's the liquid gold that powers all these classics in here. Clean fuel is critical for good engine operation. While bad fuel can not only ruin your day, it can ruin your engine. Your injector pump, fuel rail injectors, your carbies in older models, the bad fuel can destroy your spark plugs and then detonation problems. Rule number one, put the best fuel that you can get in it. And the good thing about 98 is it has the longest lifespan if you're not using your boat much. So now that we've got good fuel, the next step is keep the bad stuff out of it. We might be living in Mallacoota here, but we're not on steam. We're not steam driven. Wet stuff is best kept away from the tank at all times. One part is breathers, making sure the air can escape and water doesn't get back in. If they're poorly positioned, like mine were when I first built this, that can give you dramas. Unfortunately, every boat that I've owned has had water in the tank at some stage. It does happen. The ultimate insurance plan is this. A water separator is primary. They're cheap. And mate, it's the easiest way to get the water out of the tank. Ideally, each motor should have its own separate filter. I like to use the inspection bulb, so then you can see any water in there, you can release it, and it gives a good indication of what's going on in there. Mine are not in a nice spot, and we're going to see how they look shortly. Right, so I've turned the fuel off, and we're just going to drain it into this Morgan's cup. Right, so we've just drained a little bit of fuel out of the bulb. It actually looked better than I thought they were going to, but you can see in the bottom of that, which isn't too bad. Tool. This thing. Like I said, my fuel filters are in a really shit spot. They're on the opposite side of this panel. They're really nice and well and tucked away, but they should be right. Make a bracket up and have them there. I believe we didn't put them there because with all the ad boxes and stuff getting thrown around, we didn't want to get them smashed off. But yeah, like I say, clear view, you know what's going on then. This thing is designed to take out any water or any impurities in the fuel before it gets to your secondary filter, which is on the engine. Top of the filter, it is a paper element. And then on the bottom, we have a clear view water bowl. Luckily, water is heavier than petrol. It will always sit on the bottom. It's very easy to identify. It's visible, got a tap, get rid of it, so she's not in there anymore. Every service you should spin a new one on. It's not hard at all. Even Jack would be able to do this one. Perhaps. Yeah, cheapest insurance you're ever going to get. They set you back about 50 to 90 bucks. So the other, the secondary filter, part of the fuel system is on the engine, which is a low pressure filter, which is to stop all the dust and rust particles and stuff, or anything that might have slipped past this fella. Another good tip is always leave your boat full to slow down any condensation that may accumulate in the tank over time. So condensation is when warm air condenses and turns into moisture. So if your rig's parked up for a extended period of time, you might want to look at a fuel stabilizer. That's because evaporation causes fuel to become heavier, actually. It will make it hard to start and run like a hairy goat. It could foul a plug and then could possibly even end up as a piston detonation. Outboard spares, oh, look, like I've said it before, cheaper than genuine, and if someone can pick it from a genuine product, I'd like to hear about it. They're great communicators, they're fast. Like I say, I need stuff done yesterday when something goes wrong. But you know, I do an order up with bits and pieces and yeah, just communication, bang, it's here. They know their stuff, family business. Yeah, support locals. This is the new toy, a 1977 Bullet 1800 with a 225 two banger on the back. We had it at about 65 mile an hour. And that's basically all you could hang on to it with the steering system that's on at the minute. It got real sketchy. Why did I buy it? I've always loved going to the Southern 80 and stuff like that and going, who doesn't like going fast? And it's cheap fun. $8,000, you can be doing 80 mile an hour, you know what I mean? Motor, two stroke. Now, you gotta be careful, Cole. You're gonna try and hurt you, you're gonna try and hurt him. Yeah, so 225 Mercury, great engine, bulletproof. Well, we'll see about that. Always replace your seals. Water gets in. Mine's on the back corner. I change the seals often. Boop. So always blame the fuel attendant for bad fuel. Any age, any size, any color, any category, Outboard Spares.